Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. The gospel passage for our meditation is taken from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 10, verses 1 to 12. What kind of harvest does the Lord want us to reap today for His kingdom? When Jesus commissioned the 70 of His disciples to go on a mission, He gave them a vision of a vast field that is ready to be harvested for the kingdom of God. Jesus frequently used the image of harvest to convey the coming of God's reign on earth. The harvest is the result of much labor and growth, beginning with the sowing of seeds, then growth to maturity, and finally the reaping of the fruit for the harvest. In like manner, the word of God is sown in the hearts of receptive men and women who hear His word, accept it with trust and obedience, and then share the abundant fruit of God's word in their life with others. The harvest Jesus had in mind was not only the gathering in of the people of Israel, but all the peoples of the world. John the Evangelist tells us that God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life. What does Jesus mean when He says His disciples must be lambs in the midst of wolves? The prophet Isaiah foretold a time when wolves and lambs will dwell in peace. This certainly refers to the second coming of Lord Jesus, when all will be united under the lordship of Jesus after He has put down His enemies and established the reign of God over the heavens and on the earth. In the meantime, the disciples must expect opposition and persecution from those who would oppose the gospel. Jesus came to lay down His life for us as our sacrificial lamb, to atone for our sins and the sins of the world. We in turn must be willing to offer our lives with gratitude and humble service to our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. What is the significance of Jesus appointing 70 disciples to the ministry of the word? 70 was a significant number in biblical times. Moses chose 70 elders to help him in the task of leading the people through the wilderness. The Jewish Sanhedrin, the governing council of the nation of Israel, was composed of 70 members. In Jesus' time, 70 was held to be the number of nations throughout the world. Jesus commissioned the 70 to a twofold task: to speak in the name and to act with His power. Jesus gave His disciples instructions for how they were to carry out their ministry. They must go and serve with charity, peace, and simplicity. They must give their full attention to the proclamation of God's kingdom and not be diverted by other lesser things. They must travel light, only take what was essential and leave behind whatever would distract them, in order to concentrate on the task of speaking the word of God. They must do their work, not for what they can get out of it, but for what they can give freely to others without expecting a reward or payment. Poverty of spirit frees us from greed and preoccupation with possessions and makes ample room for God's provision. The Lord Jesus wants His disciples to be dependent on Him and not on themselves. God gives us His life-giving word that we may have abundant life in Him. He wills to walk in and through each of us for His glory. God shares His word with us, and He commissions us to speak it boldly and plainly to others. Do you witness the truth and joy of the gospel by word and example to those around you? And I pray, may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.